Hey YouTube, welcome back to another video. It is Thursday. It's about 6:30 or so, and I just made it over to my storage. Got a few things out of the way that was just stacked up in here. And so I want to keep working on the Grand Am. I need to get all this wiring situated and figured out. I know this needs to go through the firewall down there, through that hole. Gage did finally message me back about my picture of this, and he said this is all right. So the only thing I need to do is I need to get this hard line onto this side of these brake lines. So I don't know how exactly I'm supposed to do that, but that's my goal, is I've got to get that over here so it kind of snakes back here, and then it will let me twist it like this. Something like that to go in. So I guess that's just how I'm gonna have to make this work, and we'll go from there. So I'm gonna work on this a little bit, and I'll give you guys another update here shortly. All right, so I've been working on this for a little bit, and I've pretty much got the wires ran where they need to go. I did have to remove the whole clutch master and the line and everything to get it snaked out from behind those brake lines, and but that's okay. It is it's just right there. So now I actually had to take it off anyways because I never installed the clutch pedal or the push rod, and you have to install the clutch pedal and then put the push rod in there and then install the slave master. So it had to come back out anyways, but next I've got to get this installed. It goes in here something like that, and these that hole there and that hole there bolt in to the strut tower, and then there's like one or two, yeah, there's like one right there and one right there on that tab, that screw in over here on the sides right there. And that kind of just holds that in place. And then all three of these plugs go into the fuse box. And then the fuse box slides in on these two sliders here and locks in place. And so all I've got to do is I've got to go inside in the floorboard and finish pulling that harness all the way through so it will lock that grommet in that hole. And then once I do that, then I can kind of snake the wires around this piece to get it in there and sit down flush. And I've got to make sure this is a power wire for my headlights. And but yeah, it's coming along great. And then I've got the positive cable hooked up here, and then the ground is here, so both of these will reach right over here where the battery tray bolts, because the battery tray bolts in right there on those two, and the battery tray sits here. And I've got the brand new battery right there, and then the old junk one right next to it. So that brand new battery can go in here, and then the car will have power. And technically, I should be able at least to turn it over. I'll have to pull like the fuel pump fuse so I won't crank any fuel, but that'll be cool to actually crank it over with the key. So, but yeah, last time I did that, the car had no compression. It had bad piston rings. That was like 3 years ago. And ever since then, it's been an ongoing battle. This is now the third engine that I built for this car. This is the original engine block and NIC cam and everything out of the 07. Whenever it had a bad lifter, and I pulled the whole engine thinking that it had a rod knock, and it ended up being a broke lifter. And so I just, you know, kind of smoothed it out in there and was able, like once I got the old lifter out, I was able to get a new set of LS7 lifters, and it slides up and down no problem. So heads went to the machine shop, got decked. I did the 90-pound valve springs. Or no, these are like the LSX valve springs. They're like 130-something pound or something like that. So they should be good for the NIC cam. And then, I mean, I don't know, it's a Gen 5 with a North Star. And the F23 5 speed. So, factory exhaust. Still waiting on the downpipe from Gage, but man, this is going to be awesome. So, I'm going to keep working on this, and I'll give you guys another update here shortly. Alright, y'all. So, slowly making some more progress. As you can see, I've got the battery tray in. I've got this is all mounted nice and solid. So now that I've got a nice feel how this is going to go, I've got to get this back in and get it bolted back in back there. I still haven't hooked up the clutch pedal or the push rod. They are sitting in the driver floorboard. But yeah, I've got to get that done before I can really hook up the fuse box. So I guess that's probably going to be the next step. But I mean, look, got my ground is right here. It's grounded. Goes down to the bell housing right there. And then the power is here. This runs up to the fuse box. And it connects onto this stud here for the fuse box. So I mean, everything is coming together. And then with the battery here, the fuse box goes to about here. And so that's going to leave me plenty of room because this harness won't be here in my way. This will be flipped back up in the box. Let's say with that. Actually, the throttle cables go under. Let's see. Oh yeah. It's gonna be perfect. Sweet. Oh yeah. It's looking sick. I know maybe eventually I will put the battery in the trunk as well. Or at least run a second battery back there. But yeah, it's coming out awesome. So I'm gonna keep working on this thing. And I guess I'm going to try to get in there and try to get that clutch pedal bolted in so I can get that push rod in and get my slave or my clutch master bolted back up to the firewall. And then I'll be able to get the fuse box installed and get everything hooked up and clicked into place. And man, after that, I should be able to hook up the battery and at least try to crank it over and, you know, see what happens. I know it's not going to start. It's not going to have fuel. There's no injectors. But, yeah, I'm happy. So, I'm going to keep working on it. And I'll give you guys another update. Alright, you guys. Well, my phone's dying. But, look at this. So, I've got the fuse box is hooked up. The battery's in. I've got my headlights hooked up to the fuse box. Ground is grounded to the chassis and to the engine, or well, to the bell housing, and then the power goes down to the starter and up to the alternator. I've got my amp wire hooked up to the power. So watch this. Oh, I have power. For the first time in a long time, 257,000 miles on this Butte. That's awesome. Oh, look, got headlights. Oh, man. That's awesome. We got tails. That's awesome. Car has power. That's awesome. And the headlights stay on, I think, for like 15 seconds or something. There it is. That's awesome. So, it's pretty much in here, you guys. Like, it's pretty much in here. There's still a few small, minor things I need to get done. But other than that, like, it is super fucking close. I still got to get the radiator and AC condenser and all that in and get the AC lines hooked up. I still need to extend some wires to some plugs. I've still got to get the harness from Gage for the injectors and the coolant temp sensor. And then this is for the coolant temp, and it just wires into the injector harness, which I have this one back here. And so this is the 3.4 liter injector harness, and it plugs in to this plug, which is right next to the alternator. And then it gives you all six of your injectors, and then the MAP sensor, and then the coolant temp sensor. And then this one also goes down to your cam sensor. And so I sent him like three of these harnesses to Gage, and he's modifying to make it work however. And it's supposed to just plug right in. And then he's also making another part of the harness, so it just plugs right in to this plug, which is for the 3800 cam and crank sensor and coil packs. And so it's supposed to just like plug into the harness and plug into this and plug into all the injectors, and everything's just supposed to work. So once I get that other part of the harness, then I'll be able to finalize everything. And I still got to run a lot of these other wires to stuff, but it is super, super close. This is like major progress. So I just can't believe it looks like a car again. It's had power for the first time in 4 years. That is awesome.